Just a quick thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video, but we'll talk about them a little bit later on.
Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to my bedroom floor. I thought I would do a Q&A. So on Instagram, I asked you guys to ask me some questions. I said nothing was off limits. So let me find your questions and we'll get into them. There'll be loads of timestamps. So if you just are interested in certain questions, of course, you can just simply flip between them. So let's head to the bottom. This is an interesting one. People never usually ask me about these things, but how do you currently feel in your body? Do you feel better than earlier in the year? Yes, I would say I 100% feel a lot better in my body. And that's specifically because I'm someone who's always been fit. I've always been someone who goes to the gym, who's done competitive sports at school, at university. And then during the pandemic, I just completely stopped. I couldn't work out at home. I just didn't want to, but that had a really massive effect on my mental health, more so than on the way that I felt in terms of what I looked like. But in January, I decided the pandemic had been going on for such a long time that if it was gonna end anytime soon or it wasn't, I really needed to find a different solution. So I started doing Caroline Gervin workouts, getting back into weightlifting, and I kind of got my fitness back and a lot of my strength back. Yeah, I honestly feel pretty good because I feel strong and I feel fit and I don't get out of breath when I run up the stairs anymore, which is a big plus. Okay, so another question, which I think a lot of you will be probably be interested in, is how do you convince friends to be more sustainable? And this is something that I think is, there's a fine line between encouraging your friends and educating your friends and then just kind of pushing them into something that they are not interested in at all. So for example, a lot of my friends are now vegetarian and a lot of them have tried Veganuary and things like that. They also have reusable water bottles and reusable coffee cups. All of my friends are particularly politically engaged. So also lots of my friends worked for charities, work for climate change charities, like my school friends. But the way that I'll always come down to this is I think the best thing is always to lead by example. I don't believe in pushing people. I think, you know, it's easy to make things for people. Like I've bought stuff for my friends to help them be more sustainable. Yeah, I've always just been very open if they've ever had questions and just kind of said, oh, I'm doing this cool thing. It's really awesome. Or invited them to events that I've gone to and things like that. Yeah, leading by example, never pushing, never bullying, I think is like one of the best things you can do. Okay, so one of the next ones is, can you recommend any good climate crisis books? So I just wanted to take you over to my stack over here and talk about these ones. These ones right here. Okay, so I'm a huge fan of Naomi Klein. I've talked about her book, This Changes Everything, 100 million times, so I would obviously recommend that. How to Blow Up a Pipeline by Andreas Malm. Planet on Fire, A Manifesto for the Age of Environmental Breakdown by Matthew Lawrence and Laurie Leyburn Langton. I'll put this down below. I haven't finished these books yet, but I am reading them. They're very educational, very interesting. A really good one I highly recommend is The Prisoners of Geography by Tim Marshall. I read this one years ago, but I still keep it because I dip in and out, and I think that that is a really, really, really great book. I am currently reading White Skin, Black Fuel, which is on the danger of fossil fascism. I'm in a place where I'm trying desperately to learn as much as I possibly can about the environmental crisis. Everything seems to be really coming to a climax at the moment. Lots of things are happening around the world and I want to be as educated as possible. So these are just some books that I have been reading. But yeah, as I said, Naomi Klein, This Changes Everything, Prisoners of Geography by Tim Marshall, and also just kind of, I think just reading whatever you can get your hands on, to be honest. Okay, the next one. Have you ever considered continuing your academic education? Yes, I have. I've done it. I've considered it so many times. And every time I come back to the fact that I'm not someone who is very academically inclined. I love reading. I love learning. I love researching. Yeah, I've always come down to the fact that it's probably not right for me. This one's really interesting. How do you stay in touch with your friends while long distance? I lost my social skills during the pandemic. I feel, yes, so hard on this. And this is why I'm going back to London tomorrow for I'm not sure how long, because I realized when my boyfriend was here, I suddenly felt happy again and I was excited about things. And then when he left, I felt really down. And it's because I'm not spending time with my people, you know? I'm not spending time with my best friends who I have so much in common with, who I laugh with, who I love and adore. And listening to this podcast, Hidden Brain, on marriage, it kind of talks about how you're never going to be able to get all of your emotional needs met from your partner, and you shouldn't, because that's setting incredibly high expectations and you're only going to be disappointed. And this is just so true, because when my boyfriend was here, I had all my needs met and I was so like happy. And then when he went home, suddenly I was just kind of a bit like miserable again. And it's because I have got to the stage where I'm living here at the moment and I'm not investing enough time in my friendships. I'm not investing enough time, you know, seeing people and messaging people and making plans, as because I still am in this mindset that the pandemic is very much here. It's very much a thing. Whether that's right or wrong, I just decided, right, I need to make plans with my friends. I need to go back to London. I really need to see people and catch up. I have been quite bad about it throughout this whole pandemic, but I think also, you know, a lot of people have been bad about it. A lot of people will understand, and certainly my friends will understand, but I just completely reversed everything and just sat down and took some time to reply to every single text message from my friends that I hadn't replied to, reach out to other friends, make plans, and try and reconnect, because my God, I love my friends so much, and to not have them has really had a huge impact on my mental health this past year, for sure. What or where or who do you get inspired from? You're my biggest inspiration, by the way. That's so kind of you to say. Who inspires me? It's honestly such a huge mix. It can be something that I read in an article. It can be someone I found on Instagram. It can be something that one of my best friends says to me. I'm inspired by so many things and so many people, and it's because I keep putting myself out there. I keep putting myself in the way of inspiration, if you know what I mean. Like, I'll read lots of books, and from books I'll suddenly feel incredibly inspired to do something from just one line that one author has written. Or I'll watch a YouTube video by like Lena Norms, for example, and she has completely flipped something that I thought about on its head, and I'm just completely blown away by her perspective. And then that really inspires me to go and look at something further and motivates me to change my behavior in some way. I just want to take a small break to say thank you so much to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. Squarespace gives people a powerful and beautiful online platform from which to create your website. You can connect with your audience and generate revenue through gated members-only content, manage your members and send email communications, and leverage audience insights. I love creating a community over on Squarespace because I can use their fully integrated commenting system that supports threaded comments, replies, and likes. So if you're interested, head to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/sustainablyvegan to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Okay, what's the next one? Hey friends, so I'm back in London now. I'm gonna answer some more questions, and I'm also gonna be decluttering my room today because, as I said, when I do move, one of my friends is taking over my room. Okay, which platform do you earn most of your money off per year? So I earn most of my money from, when I say YouTube, I think YouTube. I have, you know, almost three times the amount of subscribers on YouTube than I do on Instagram. I have only in the past year started doing a lot more branded work on Instagram. I prefer to do it on YouTube because I just like keeping Instagram less sort of addy and less businessy and more kind of being able to post whatever I want. I don't work with that many companies, although it probably might seem like I do, but I try. I honestly say no to like 90% of people who offer me things. Although I think a lot of people have stopped offering me things which they know I'm gonna say no to. YouTube, I did earn more, but with AdSense, because I stopped monetizing my videos in the middle, so I didn't put any adverts in the middle of my videos anymore. I was earning like £2,000 a month from AdSense, and now I'm earning about £700 a month from AdSense. But that's also because the US government now taxes my income from AdSense because it's a US company. Boggles my mind because I'm not a US citizen, I don't live in the US, but yeah. So yeah, I earn about £700 a month from AdSense, and then all the other money that I earn are from either brand deals on YouTube, brand deals on Instagram, and Patreon. So yeah, that's why I love Patreon, because we can talk about whatever we want. What else? Okay, if you weren't doing this as a career, what would you hope to do, or what career would you hope to have? I think if I didn't do this full time, I probably would have stayed doing what I was doing before. So I used to work for a social impact charity that helped economically disadvantaged young people in the UK. And then I did move to be a storyboard producer. Probably now I would either work again with young people or for a sort of women and girls charity. Okay, I'm back in Sussex because I was terrible at filming in London. So we're gonna do a quick fire round because you know how I love to ramble. I've also got my hat on because my hair is the frizziest it's been in a really long time. Okay, quick fire. What does the whale mean on your arm, if you're willing to share? Yes, it is a very hard topic for me to talk about, and this is why I've never talked about it before, because a lot of my tattoos are not personal, they're just beautiful artwork that I personally love and I love the artist, but this is very different. It was covering up something that was very not indicative of who I am now, but a kind of significant past of mine when I had some pretty difficult mental challenges when I was much younger, 13, 14 years old, and that does not representative of who I am now. So I wanted something beautiful, but also I personally feel like whales are the guardians of the oceans. You know, they are really important for the ecosystem and they kind of just take care of things. So I thought, why not get something that I feel like will take care of me? I know it's a bit cheesy, but like I love it and it keeps me safe. Where do you think you are going to move to? So I personally think that we're gonna end up in somewhere like Colorado, maybe Denver, maybe Boulder, maybe Colorado Springs, maybe another city that we, you know, isn't talked about as much online. But if you have any tips, obviously let me know. I would love to live in the Pacific Northwest, but it's just, it seems to be very, very, very expensive. And even though we will probably end up in, you know, a small flat because we don't need a big space, who knows? How do you keep your curls healthy and low waste? Okay, the single best thing that I have done is to get a curly girl specific haircut. And I got one recently and it completely changed the game. And that's why everyone seems to be commenting on my hair, because it just looks different. It's so much more healthy, bouncy. It actually has a proper shape to it rather than just hanging down. It also could be the products that I'm using. I use a deep conditioner once every 2 weeks. I'm still using the Faith in Nature ones that I talked about a couple of months ago. I use an Etique hair care bar. Next week I'm actually coming out with a collab with a friend on curly hair, so I will let you know more then. How's your immigration process coming along? So we filed our paperwork in April and have heard nothing since. We've only heard that they've received it, so it's going very, very, very slow. Do you do the videography, editing, and other works, your YouTube alone? Yes, I do absolutely everything alone. The only thing I have help with is I have a manager to do all my brand deal stuff, so I don't have to worry about emails and things like that. At the moment, I plan all my videos, I think of all my ideas, I film everything myself, which takes a really long time. I edit everything myself, I upload everything myself, I write all my blog posts, except I finally hired someone to help me with sort of general admin stuff, but to turn my videos into blog posts. And I am very, very grateful for their presence in my life. So hopefully you'll get much more blog posts for every video that we do. And I am currently looking for a video editor. I have a call with someone this week. So hopefully, fingers crossed, if I get an editor, I'll be able to get way more videos out to you because I'll have more time to think, plan, and film. Your fears and worries about moving to the US, it's such a big step. And also in this, why are you moving to the US? So I'm moving to the US because temporarily I want to be with my fiance there. We're gonna get married. He has a job. It doesn't make sense for him to leave his job now in COVID times, especially when I can work from anywhere. He's gonna move to the UK permanently afterwards. So I think it's only fair if we spend time with his family, his friends. My fears, well, the big things, you know, healthcare we have to pay for. The American health system really freaks me out, especially the dentist industry as well. Someone who's had bad issues with their teeth, that makes me feel unsafe. American politics worries me. I mean, there's no end to the things that worry me about moving to the US, but at the same time, like, I don't know. How long will you live in the US before returning? I think maximum about 3 years, but I will never say never. I don't know. How was your summer? Really great and really shit. There were lots of highs, lots of lows. I saw some wonderful friends and I also missed them terribly. I had my boyfriend here and he also left. I spent time with my family and they got overwhelming. To be honest, I can't really complain. Is your fiance vegan or plant-based? I would say he's plant-based. He doesn't call himself vegan. He pretty much eats plant-based at home. He doesn't eat meat or fish, but yeah. When are you planning on getting married? We are planning on getting married as soon as possible, but there's not gonna be like a wedding until we move back to the UK. Yeah. Are you still not sure about having a baby? yeah, I'm not sure. Would you ever consider including meat in your diet again? No, I just never miss it, to be honest. Even if I wasn't doing it for sort of animal rights reasons, I don't miss it at all. I never crave it. I don't feel like my body needs it. I haven't had any health issues since being vegan. But yeah, I just don't miss it. So I don't feel like I would ever eat it again. Favorite place in the UK? Definitely Wales. I think Wales is so underrated. Wonderful people, beautiful country, incredible beaches, incredible mountains. Oh, there are so many more questions, but I just don't have time to finish them. I think I'll do another one of these and answer the rest of these questions in a couple of weeks, if that's okay. If you like this video, I hope you did. And yeah, any more questions, leave them in the comments below and I will just answer them there as well. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked it and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye.